205. Pfizer will likely have the first vaccine made available to the public, but it needs to be stored in extremely cold temperatures, raising logistical issues. Sarah Madison spoke to a UH vaccinologist and has more.
Dr. Axel Lehrer tells us proper storage is probably one of the biggest logistical problems that comes with the Pfizer vaccine.
You know, if the vaccine has deviated from the recommended storage temperature, then you don't know whether it's going to work.
Dr. Lehrer tells us Oahu has some supplies, but it could be a lot harder for the neighbor islands.
I don't think we have any large scale storage for this. So, you know, there will be, you know, people will have to buy, you know, new freezers and so on. But we have a facility here that makes liquid nitrogen and dry ice on Oahu. So on Oahu, we may be in slightly better shape.
He says he's noticed a recent shortage in the supply chain for ultra-cold freezers needed to store vaccines.
These are normal things that we use in the biomedical research field. So we have a lot of them in our lab. But, you know, a normal pharmacy or a doctor's office or even a hospital, they typically don't or may have one of those kind of freezers. So that's what the limitation here is.
The Queen's Medical Center says it's working with the state.
So the vaccine responsibility is actually at the state level. Queens is going to be a partner in this work, and this issue of how are we going to store the vaccine and what are the logistics of distributing the vaccine is something at the state level, the county level, and all of the health systems levels we're talking about to ensure we have the resources to make it happen when the vaccine becomes available.
Dr. Lehrer is excited to learn that a vaccine for this virus is possible.
We actually can develop a successful and efficacious vaccine. That's the really good news of this week.
Sarah Madison, KHON2 News, working for Hawaii.
More restaurants could be closing down for good as they use up what's left of federal funding, while the